This is Dr. Keith Miller, and I will be discussing the formation and characteristics of metamorphic foliation. Metamorphism is the alteration of existing rocks by high temperatures, hot fluids, and/or high pressures. Rocks are placed under tremendous directional pressure during the deformation and uplift of mountain ranges. This type of metamorphism is called regional metamorphism because it affects a very large area. The directional pressures generate a variety of oriented textures called foliation. The word foliation simply means to be separated into layers. Metamorphic foliation is the preferred orientation of mineral grains within a rock, giving it a layered or a striped, sometimes called lineated, appearance. The orientation of these minerals is typically at 90 degrees to the maximum direction of applied force. So if I'm applying a force this way, then the minerals will be oriented 90 degrees from that maximum pressure. Examples of foliated rocks include slate, phyllite, schist, and gneiss. So in some cases, foliation will look like this, with very, very thin, very flat planar layers. In other cases, somewhat thicker and more wavy layers. And in other cases, banded layering. Or even kind of lines looking like lined up pencils called lineation. The directed pressures or forces produce foliated textures in several different ways. When rocks are compressed, rounded or equidimensional mineral grains may become flattened in the direction of the maximum force. This can be illustrated by this block of Play-Doh that has embedded rounded grains within it. So these rounded red pieces of Play-Doh represent equidimensional grains within the rock. So I'll compress this by applying a force in a single direction. And then we can cut through this and see how those initially rounded grains have now formed distinct layers within the rock. So this is an example of the formation of foliation by the compression of and deformation of originally round or equidimensional grains. Another way in which foliation is formed is by the rotation of grains in response to directed pressure. Grains that are oriented by the compressive forces are rotated about 90 degrees to the direction of maximum force. This is illustrated by pressing this pencil between my hands. As I bring my hands together, that pencil is rotated, just like mineral grains are rotated in the same way as this pencil. So a grain that is originally oriented against the direction of pressure will over time be turned rotated so that now its long dimension is 90 degrees to the applied pressure. Mineral grains can also be smeared out by shearing. This happens especially with minerals with well-developed cleavage. The mineral will shear or slip along those planes of weaknesses in the crystal. This shearing action can be illustrated by a stack of playing cards. Pressing or shearing that stack of cards will cause them to be smeared out in a plane. So if I press this stack of cards, I can spread them out, smear them out, and the contact between these different cards would be very much analogous to the cleavage planes in a mineral. Lastly, as rocks are heated during metamorphism, new minerals begin to grow in the rock. The new minerals that grow under the directional forces of regional metamorphism will develop a preferred orientation, as we've seen. Sheet silicates, such as micas and minerals that form elongated crystals, will grow with their sheets or directions of elongation oriented perpendicular to the direction of maximum compressive force. So as the rocks are being compressed, new minerals are growing in the rock, and those new minerals are preferentially going to grow at right angles to the direction in which the rock is being compressed. This is because the growth of such minerals is easier along directions of least force. The growth of sheet silicate minerals in preferred directions will result in a planar foliation along which the rock will break. Rocks can also be metamorphosed under conditions in which there is no directional force being applied. Such rocks do not show foliation and are called non-foliated. Rocks can be intensely heated by igneous intrusions, and this type of metamorphism is called contact metamorphism. Since the rocks are being baked in contact with a hot molten magma, this baking will cause the breakdown and recrystallization of some minerals and the crystallization of new minerals. However, these minerals will not grow in any preferred orientation and thus will not be foliated. Examples of such rocks are marble, quartzite, and hornfels. So again, these would be examples of non-foliated rocks in which the rocks show no preferred orientation, no banding, or no tendency to break off into sheets. And that's because these rocks have been heated in a way in which there has been no directional pressure applied. So these are all non-foliated metamorphic rocks.